Welcome to Green Living. I'm Paolo Abrera, and I wear a lot of hats. Well, not literally, of course. I mean that I have a lot of roles in life. Aside from my day job, I'm a husband, a father, a sports enthusiast, and I love to dabble in the kitchen. In fact, I find cooking to be very therapeutic, and one of my favorite things to do is to prepare healthy, delicious meals using organic ingredients that don't sacrifice on intense flavors. And that's exactly what we're going to be doing today. We're going to prepare a healthy, delicious meal using a fruit, or is it a vegetable, that everybody knows? The tomato. The Lycopersicum esculentum, or the tomato, translates to wolf peach. It was called a peach because it was round and luscious, and wolf because, if you can believe it, it was once widely considered to be poisonous. Funny fact, isn't it? Especially considering just how widely used tomatoes are in kitchens all over the world. In fact, most chefs agree that along with onions and garlic, tomatoes are the one ingredient you should always have stocked around the home. Tomatoes are actually a fruit and not a vegetable, and are chock full of all kinds of health benefits for the body. They are a highly versatile health product, and due to how versatile they are to prepare, there's really no reason to neglect the tomato as part of a healthy diet. Yep, this guy is packed with all kinds of healthy benefits, and we'll get to the details a little later on. Now, we all know how delicious this fruit is, and in a little while, I'm going to show you how ridiculously easy it is to prepare one of my all-time favorite hearty meals. But in the meantime, let's check out some equally hearty eats from Green's Restaurant. I'm Paolo Abrera, and this is Green Living. There's a trend today that greatly values restaurant-style food. More and more people are eating out, be it for convenience or for a changing palate. One of the newer trends in the industry is the growing number of vegetarian restaurants that have popped up all over the metro. This is definite proof of a growing palate and a diversifying lifestyle. One of the first vegetarian restaurants to appear around 11 years ago is a quaint little place in Quezon City, Green's Restaurant.
My name is Jardan Duran. I'm the marketing manager of Green's. Green's Restaurant is a 100% lacto-vegetarian restaurant. We have an international vegetarian cuisine. So we have like from American food like burgers, we have Italian like pasta, we have wraps, we have Filipino traditional dishes and all sorts of different cuisines.
For the Duran family, vegetarianism was more than just a lifestyle. And what started out as a passion project by their patriarch soon developed into a full-blown business.
It started with my dad, like when he was a teenager. When he turned vegetarian, he was about 14. And he's always wanted to be in a restaurant business. And it was only until like 2001 that he realized that dream.
The Duran family has taken vegetarianism to a new level. Not only are all its members full vegetarians, but the children have been so since birth.
Yes, I'm a vegetarian since conception. So is my sister. Our family of four, we're all vegetarians. My dad turned vegetarian when he was 14. And my mom turned vegetarian when she married my dad. And me and my sister, we were born and raised vegetarian.
Despite a non-typical upbringing, Jardan grew up with the same recipes that Green's Restaurant is known for today.
I've been vegetarian since birth, and even when I was in school, they tease me or make fun of, like, what are you having? Every time it's lunch or recess, they check out what I have. But then when they start tasting, even back then, you know, and it's not that bad. I mean, it actually tastes good, and that's actually how we put up the menu. I mean, like, our barbecue was a recipe for my first birthday. I mean, my mom made that for that day, so, and you gotta try it, you know.
Great tasting doesn't even begin to describe the delicious, mouth-watering vegetarian options that the Durans have to offer.
The veggies wrap has a variety of vegetables inside. You have zucchini, onions, and some leafy greens. We have bell peppers, and you can opt to have cheese or without cheese for vegans. And it's wrapped in a whole wheat wrapper. The Greens House Salad is composed of leafy greens, arugula, pineapple, cucumber, black olives, corn, and the dressing is honey mustard. Okay, our escabeche has that fishy taste from the seaweed. It's soybean curd wrapped in seaweed, wrapped in another layer of bean curd. And we have a sweet and sour sauce. Our sisig, bestseller, is mostly made of gluten and some Japanese tofu. As you can have onions or without onions. Our kebabs has mushrooms, green bell peppers, our vegetarian barbecue, our tofu, our zucchini, and onions.
Deliciously homey recipes such as these lie at the heart of Green's restaurant. The restaurant represents an ideal that the Durans fiercely believe in and have shared with a growing clientele.
I think Green's has that loyal customer base because of it's different factors. Like there's, of course, the ambiance. You go in here, it's very relaxing. And the food, even the music, and the type of music we play. And, you know, number one would be the food. And maybe second would be the personal touch. I mean, our family is like really involved here. We're not in it really just for money. It's an advocacy. So my parents especially are really involved in talking to people.
The act of sharing their personal recipes through their restaurant is representative of the Duran family's general outlook towards the business. A homey, personal touch.
We love this business because it's so personal. I mean, it's not you come here and buy our stuff and then we sell it to you. It's really, we're developing relationships with the people we deal with. And, you know, we've had customers from, like, they were kids. They started coming here, they were kids, and now they're, like, in high school. Or some are, like, you know, college, and now they're, like, now they have, like, kids, you know, so we know these people. It's not just, you know, nameless faces, you know. We know the people who come here, and they know us. So that's part of the charm of my restaurant, I guess.
And charm is the perfect way to describe this picturesque little restaurant. With personal touches in the decor, the warmth of the food, and the pleasantries of the company, you slowly get to realize one thing, that being home isn't just an adjective to describe it. Green's Resto actually is the home of the Duran family.
When you come in, you get this homey ambiance. And the reason is because it is actually our home. You actually go in, it's our garage. You walk up and it's our garden. And you open our front door and it's really our house. So it's literally like a homey atmosphere because we actually live practically next to it.
Diners today may be looking for restaurant-style cuisine, but there will always be a soft spot for home-style cooking. At Green's Restaurant, that's just what you get. Delicious food, cooked with a passionate touch.
Welcome back to Green Living. Today we're going to learn how to make a homey, hearty recipe using the amazing tomato. Now we say it's amazing because, well, it really is. It's packed with nutrients and health benefits like lycopene. One of the best known benefits of eating tomatoes is its lycopene content. Lycopene is a vital antioxidant that helps in the fight against the formation of cancer cells, as well as other health complications and diseases. A single tomato can provide about 40% of daily vitamin C requirements. Vitamin C is a natural antioxidant which acts against cancer-causing free radicals. It also contains abundant vitamin A and potassium, as well as iron. Add to that the fact that tomatoes are also good for your skin and they counteract the effects of toxins produced by smoking, and even you have to admit that this little guy truly is a wonder. Amazing, isn't it? But we haven't gotten to the best part yet. The reason that I love preparing hearty meals is that it always reminds me of home. And what's wrong with preparing something like that? Right here. Today we're going to be preparing a staple. Creamy tomato basil soup made from scratch. Ooh, my mouth is watering just thinking about it. We'll get to that recipe in just a bit, but in the meantime, let's meet somebody who has taken her passion for running a notch higher.
My name is Jamie Crisostomo-Pizarro, and I am a graphic designer. I'm a US certified baby sign language instructor. I'm a blogger, and I'm also the editor-in-chief of the Bull Runner magazine. And I'm a mom to two kids, and a wife. The start was I walked, and then it became walk-run. And then you eventually run more than you walk until like 2 months after I could run for 2 minutes straight. So that for me was a big achievement. I joined my first race in March 2007, the Pinayan Action Race. It was a 5K race and I was so worried that I'd come in last or that I'd suffer and not reach the finish line. The typical anxieties of a beginner. But once I did cross the finish line, I told my husband I'm completely in love with this whole thing. When I signed up, I liked the fact that I was moving out of my comfort zone and I was scaring myself, going into a territory that was unknown. It was a process that I gradually learned to adjust to my own schedule and to manage my time properly. If like I needed to do something with the kids, then the thing is I would just wake up earlier to run. If I had the graphic design project with a looming deadline, then I wouldn't sleep and finish that project just so I could run the next day. Things like that. It's a day-to-day thing, I think, especially for a mom like me who just has a crazy schedule. You just learn to live with it and manage everything. The blog, thebullrunner.com, wasn't really something I thought about. It came impulsively. By that time, I had been running for like 6 months alone on the treadmill. And I was just so passionate about running. And I'd always talk about it with my friends, my girlfriends, and my husband, but none of them were runners. And I didn't know a single runner out there. So I just felt like I needed an outlet. In 2007, if you wanted to join a race, it's not like now that you just go online and everything's there. There was no resource. Actually, I'd read through the newspapers every day looking for races. And once in a while there would be, then I'd sign up for that. But there was no list, comprehensive list. So I decided to also include that in the blog. The only time that it really hit me that it was getting bigger was when I won the Philippine Blog Awards. The blog won the best single post in the sports category and the best blog in the sports category, which were basically the only two awards in the sports category. Yeah, so that was in 2008. And that's the only time I said, oh no, you know, a lot of people actually read what I write. I called it the Bull Runner because it was my birthday, and by that time I think I was suffering through some injuries already, and I was being bullheaded about it, that I think the doctor even told me, you know, you need surgery, you better stop running. I was like, no way. I cried for a bit because I thought I could never run again, but said, no way, I'm gonna keep on running. I'm bullheaded. I also worked in the stock market for a while, so I knew that a bull run always was something positive. The magazine, again, wasn't really something that I sat down and wrote a business plan about. I think that's the thing with me. Most of what I set up really come from my passion. I'm a graphic designer that used to specialize in newsletters. So it came naturally, I guess. The blog was there. Most of my friends were in the running community. Even the suppliers, the stores, the running stores, I knew everyone there. It was like 1 week. And I just said, you know, I think I'll make a magazine because I can do it all on my own. And so I did. So I launched in 2008 the Bull Runner magazine, the same name as the blog. It's fun because it doesn't feel like work. The blog and the magazine, down to the shoots, our photographers are runner, our writers are all runners, our printer was even a runner. So, you know, it's all of my friends just working together for the love of running. So the story of the Bull Runner Dream Marathon started when I crossed the finish line of my first marathon. It was such a positive experience. When I crossed the finish line, I literally felt like I was changed. Because suddenly I thought, wow, if I survive that, I can do anything in my life. It's like everything else is easy. Jim Lafferty was the key person because he was the one who told me, why don't you create your own race? And I was first hesitant. I was like, no way, it's too difficult. He said, no, let's do it. We said, we're gonna create a marathon, especially for first-time marathoners, because we want to give them the ideal first marathon experience. Because when you cross the finish line of your first marathon, it's like one of the most memorable moments of your life. My condition was that everyone there has to be positive. Everyone has to be cheerful. There should be no mayabang, intimidating runners who will say that I run farther than you and I can do better. So what another thing that makes the Bull Runner Dream Marathon different is that we have a 22-week training program. We have run clinics, which are called Bull Sessions, and we have Bull Circles, which are the running talks. Our goal is not really for speed, but we go through a program which is a run-walk program. So it's for beginners. We teach you intervals so that you reach the finish line feeling strong and feeling still like you have energy. We give you all those training for free. Before I run, really, I just go out and run. I start out the first 1 or 2 kilometers running easy. It's like a light jog. It's the warm-up already. A lot of people think that you're supposed to stretch before you exercise, but the truth is you're not supposed to stretch cold muscles. So it's advised that you warm up by there, light jogging or walking, and then you run, and then after, when your muscles are warmed up, that's when you stretch. Yes, it's possible to fit something as great as running, as big as running into your life. Hey, if it's not running, it could be some other thing, but you can have your passion and give 100% into your passion and still be there for your career and your family and for all your other responsibilities in life. It changed my life. Upside down, it changed me. I think before running, my life was pretty simple. I was just at home, taking care of the kids. I had graphic design there, and I was happy. But I think now I'm a lot stronger mentally, a lot more positive about life, a lot more adventurous. Now I think there's so much out there to experience and to conquer and to achieve. And I'm always there for the challenge now. It's like this, life is so short. You want to grab it by the horns like a bull and live it to the fullest.
Welcome back to Green Living. Are you guys ready to make some tomato soup?
I know I am.
So let's just dive straight in. You'll need 28 ounces of crushed tomatoes, 14.5 ounces of chicken broth, about 18 fresh basil leaves minced, 1 teaspoon sugar, 1 cup whipping cream, and half a cup of butter or margarine, as well as salt and pepper to taste. In a large saucepan, bring the tomatoes and broth to a boil. Reduce heat and cover and simmer for about 10 minutes. Add basil and sugar and reduce the heat to low. Stir in the cream and butter and cook until the butter is melted. wasn't that easy? An instant, hearty, gourmet meal. And since we chose to use organic ingredients, it's definitely better for the environment as well. But wait, you can't have tomato soup without pairing it with a grilled cheese sandwich. Now, you may have your own grilled cheese recipe, but I like to top mine off with some finely sliced tomato pieces before popping it into the grill. It makes for a wonderfully fresh sandwich. So pair these together and you have got magic. Well, that's it for me. I'm gonna leave you for now so that I can bond with my food. If you're looking for more tips and behind-the-scenes notes, you can log on to www.greenliving-tv.com or follow us on Twitter and find our Facebook page and maybe leave a tip or two, just like Ralph O'Malley, who uses old toilet paper rolls to organize his cables. What a brilliant idea. I'll see you guys next week, right here on Green Living. Aside from my day job, I'm a husband, a father, a sports enthusiast. In a little while, I'm going to show you how to prepare one of my all-time ridiculous meals. Details in a little while. Yeah, details later on. Now, we all know how delicious the tomato. Little antioxidant that helps in the age.